Pertuzumab is an antineoplastic agent used in the treatment of HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer in combination with other antineoplastic agents. In this video, let's find found. What is pertuzumab? What is pertuzumab used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking pertuzumab? How does pertuzumab work? How to use pertuzumab? What is pertuzumab? Pertuzumab, sold under the brand name Perjeta, is a monoclonal antibody used in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel for the treatment of metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer. It also used in the same combination as a neoadjuvant in early HER2-positive breast cancer. It was discovered and developed by Genentech and was first approved in 2012. What is pertuzumab used for? Pertuzumab is indicated for intravenous administration in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel for the treatment of patients with HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer who have not received prior anti-HER2 therapy or chemotherapy for metastatic disease. It is also indicated in combination with trastuzumab and other chemotherapies for the neoadjuvant treatment of HER2-positive locally advanced, inflammatory, or early-stage breast cancer as part of a complete treatment regimen 6 and as adjuvant treatment in patients with HER2-positive early-stage breast cancer at high risk of recurrence. Pertuzumab is also indicated for subcutaneous injection in combination with trastuzumab and hyaluronidase in the treatment of HER2-positive breast cancers in adults. Side effects. Common side effects of pertuzumab, greater than or equal to 10% incidence, include black, tarry stools, burning, numbness, tingling, or painful sensations, chills, cough, fast heartbeat, fever, hives, itching, or rash, hoarseness. Pharmacodynamic. Pertuzumab exerts its antineoplastic effects by binding to and inhibiting the activity of HER2, an oncogene that has been implicated in the formation of numerous cancers. As with other therapeutic monoclonal antibodies, pertuzumab has a relatively long duration of action, necessitating every 3 weeks. Drugs that block HER2 activity, including pertuzumab, have been implicated in the development of cardiotoxicity, specifically left ventricular dysfunction. A baseline assessment of left ventricular ejection fraction, LVEF, should be conducted prior to beginning therapy with pertuzumab and at regular intervals throughout therapy to ensure LVEF remains within normal limits. Consider indefinite suspension of therapy if LVEF declines and does not improve. Mechanism of action. Human epidermal growth factor receptor 2, HER2, is a tyrosine kinase receptor that plays an integral role in cell proliferation, differentiation, and survival. HER2 becomes active following dimerization with another HER2 receptor, another member of the HER protein family, HER3, or with a ligand. This dimer then phosphorylates and activates numerous intracellular signaling proteins, initiating signal transduction via pathways that include the RAS/mitogen-activated protein kinase pathway, the phosphatidylinositol 3-foot kinase, PI3K/ACT pathway, then Janus kinases/signal transducer and activator transcription pathway. Pertuzumab targets the extracellular dimerization domain, subdomain 2, of HER2, thereby inhibiting ligand-initiated intracellular signaling via the MAP kinase and PI3K pathways. Inhibition of these ways results in inhibition of cell growth and the initiation of apoptosis, respectively. Pertuzumab also appears to mediate antibody-dependent cell-mediated cytotoxicity. Half-life. The median half-life of pertuzumab was determined to be 18 days, based on a population pharmacokinetic analysis. Dose. Metastatic breast cancer. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel for HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer in patients who have not received prior anti-HER2 therapy or chemotherapy for metastatic disease. Initial dose, 840 mg 4 infusion 60 minutes, then 420 mg for infusion over 30 to 60 minutes, q3 weeks thereafter. Trastuzumab, 8 mg per kilogram for infusion over 90 minutes initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for infusion over 30 to 90 minutes, q3 weeks thereafter. Doxil, 75 mg per square meter for infusion initially, may increase to 100 mg per square meter for infusion q3 weeks if initial dose is well tolerated. Early breast cancer. Neoadjuvant treatment. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab, or trastuzumab hyaluronidase or docetaxel for the neoadjuvant treatment of patients with HER2-positive, locally advanced, inflammatory, or early-stage breast cancer, either greater than 2 cm in diameter or node-positive, as part of a complete treatment regimen for early breast cancer. Initial dose, pertuzumab 840 mg for infusion, then 420 mg for infusion q3 weeks and trastuzumab 8 mg per kilogram for infusion initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for infusion q3 weeks or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc 600 mg/10,000 units, 600 mg trastuzumab and 10,000 units hyaluronidase SC q3 weeks irrespective of body weight. Docetaxel 75 mg per square meter for infusion initially, may increase to 100 mg per square meter for infusion q3 weeks if initial dose is well tolerated. Administer sequentially, pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc can be given in any order. Taxane should be administered after pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc. Neoadjuvant dosage regimens. Administered q3 weeks for 3 to 6 cycles, part of one of the following treatment regimens for early breast cancer. For preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel, followed by 3 postoperative cycles of fluorouracil, epirubicin, and cyclophosphamide, FEC, as given in the Neosphere trial. 3 or 4 preoperative cycles of FEC alone, followed by 3 or 4 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with docetaxel and trastuzumab as given in Trifonina and Berenice trials. 6 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with docetaxel, carboplatin, and trastuzumab, TCH, escalation of docetaxel above 75 mg per square meter is not recommended, as given in Trifonina trial. For preoperative cycles of dose-dense doxorubicin and cyclophosphamide, DDAC, alone followed by 4 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with paclitaxel and trastuzumab as given in Berenice trial. Following surgery, patients should continue to receive trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc to complete 1 year of treatment, up to 18 cycles. Adjuvant treatment. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc and chemotherapy for adjuvant treatment of patients with HER2-positive early breast cancer at high risk of recurrence. Initial dose, pertuzumab 840 mg for infusion, then 420 mg for infusion q3 weeks and trastuzumab 8 mg per kilogram for initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for q3 weeks or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc 600 mg/10,000 units, 600 mg trastuzumab and 10,000 units hyaluronidase SC q3 weeks irrespective of body weight. For a total of 1 year, up to 18 cycles, or until disease recurrence or unmanageable toxicity ever occurs first, as part of a complete regimen for early breast cancer, including standard anthracycline and or taxane-based chemotherapy as given in Affinity trial. Pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc should start on day 1 of the first taxane-containing cycle. Dose. Metastatic breast cancer. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel for HER2-positive metastatic breast cancer in patients who have not received prior anti-HER2 therapy or chemotherapy for metastatic disease. Initial dose, 840 mg for infusion over 60 minutes, then 420 mg for infusion over 30 to 60 minutes, q3 weeks thereafter. Trastuzumab, 8 mg per kilogram for infusion over 90 minutes initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for infusion over 30 to 90 minutes, q3 weeks thereafter. Doxil, 75 mg per square meter for infusion initially, may increase to 100 mg per square meter for infusion q3 weeks if initial dose is well tolerated. Early breast cancer. Neoadjuvant treatment. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab, or trastuzumab hyaluronidase or endostaxel for the neoadjuvant treatment of patients with HER2-positive, locally advanced, inflammatory, or early-stage breast cancer, either greater than 2 cm in diameter or node-positive, as part of a complete treatment regimen for early breast cancer. Initial dose, pertuzumab 840 mg for infusion, then 420 mg for infusion q3 weeks and trastuzumab 8 mg per kilogram for infusion initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for infusion q3 weeks or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc 600 mg/10,000 units, 600 mg trastuzumab and 10,000 units hyaluronidase, sq3 weeks irrespective of body weight. Docetaxel, 75 mg per square meter for infusion initially, may increase to 100 mg per square meter for infusion q3 weeks if initial dose is well tolerated. Administer sequentially. Pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc can be given in any order. Taxane should be administered after pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc. Neoadjuvant dosage regimens. Administered q3 weeks for 3 to 6 cycles, part of one of the following treatment regimens for early breast cancer. For preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with trastuzumab and docetaxel, followed by 3 postoperative cycles of fluorouracil, epirubicin, and cyclophosphamide, FEC, as given in the Neosphere trial. 3 or 4 preoperative cycles of FEC alone, followed by 3 or 4 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with docetaxel and trastuzumab as given in Trifonina and Berenice trials. 6 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with docetaxel, carboplatin, and trastuzumab, TCH, escalation of docetaxel above 75 mg per square meter is not recommended, as given in Trifonina trial. For preoperative cycles of dose-dense doxorubicin and cyclophosphamide, DDAC, alone followed by 4 preoperative cycles of pertuzumab in combination with paclitaxel and trastuzumab as given in Berenice trial. Following surgery, patients should continue to receive trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc to complete 1 year of treatment, up to 18 cycles. Adjuvant treatment. Indicated in combination with trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc and chemotherapy for adjuvant treatment of patients with HER2-positive early breast cancer at high risk of recurrence. Initial dose, pertuzumab 840 mg for infusion, then 420 mg for infusion q3 weeks and trastuzumab 8 mg per kilogram for initially, then 6 mg per kilogram for q3 weeks or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc 600 mg/10,000 units, 600 mg trastuzumab and 10,000 units hyaluronidase, sq3 weeks irrespective of body weight. For a total of 1 year, up to 18 cycles, or until disease recurrence or unmanageable toxicity ever occurs first, as part of a complete regimen for early breast cancer, including standard anthracycline and or taxane-based chemotherapy as given in Affinity trial. Pertuzumab and trastuzumab or trastuzumab hyaluronidase oisc should start on day 1 of the first taxane-containing cycle. That's all the information about pertuzumab we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.